Not to sound cliche here, but the future is now. The almighty internet, super smart digital devices, talking robots with artificial intelligence. All these things we have today only existed in sci-fi books and movies not too long ago. Humans and machines live side by side, but technology is getting closer than you think. Like under your skin. It all started in Sweden in the spring of 2018. Since then, about 4,000 people have gotten microchips put into their hands, and this number only keeps growing. Although this recent implantable form is new to us, the technology, which is known as radio frequency identification, RFID, has been around for decades and has long been considered secure enough for common use. Ear chips are used to register almost all farm animals. We even put them in our pets so we can find them in case they get lost. In some airlines, you can thank RFID luggage tags for the fact that your suitcases arrive at the same destination you do. And you probably already have a personal RFID chip that goes everywhere with you. It's in your bank card. Well, this implantable chip for people is supposed to make our lives a lot easier. But before I tell you what exactly it's for, let me first tell you what getting chipped really involves. The chip is about the size of a grain of rice, and it's surgically inserted into the hand in the area between the thumb and index finger. This little procedure is as painful as getting a shot. So you might just flinch if you're super sensitive, but that's it. Also, you won't see any blood. Once it's been inserted, the chip isn't visible whatsoever, and only its owner will know it's actually there. But if someone feels like bragging about it to their friends or coworkers, then it could be seen from a particular angle on the skin as a tiny bump. And of course, your doctor will notice it if your hand gets x-rayed. Now the question that's on everyone's mind, what is this thing actually for? Well, have you ever forgotten your wallet or keys at home? Yeah, we've all been there. But with this chip, you won't even need that stuff anymore. People who have this microchip can use it as a pass card to enter buildings, as a bank card to pay for anything they want, to get train or concert tickets, and even as a key to start their car. You can also use it to get access to all your social media accounts. All this can be done by a simple wave of the hand. Sounds pretty fantastic, right? No more fishing through your bag, trying to find your wallet, or even worrying about someone stealing it. As for the days of losing your keys or missing a workout just because you forgot to grab your gym pass, they'd be no more too. Although, on the downside, there goes your excuse for showing up late to work or skipping the gym. This innovation will make traveling a lot safer and more convenient too, since you won't have to worry about losing your documents. Swedish people are already enjoying the perks of the chipped life. For example, they don't have to get tickets for train trips. Instead of a piece of paper with a barcode, the train crew just scans their chip and sees their ticket in the system. On top of that, several Swedish companies have opted to get their employees chipped for free so that they can access the workplace easier, log into computers, use photocopiers, and even pay for cafeteria food. A few companies in other countries are starting to follow their lead. But how does it all work? You see, a chip is basically a storage place for digital information. It can contain not only the details of your bank account and your purchases, your ID and passwords to your house, office, and social media profiles, but also medical information such as your blood type or a list of things you're allergic to. Just like those tap and pay contactless cards and mobile payments, the small implants work with the help of near-field communication technology. This means that the chip only works if it's about an inch away from the reader that activates it. A small amount of data then flows between the two devices via electromagnetic waves. The implants, however, only contain information that other devices can read. They can't read information themselves. So don't expect to borrow your friend's car by shaking their hand. The chips are definitely aimed at saving people a lot of time and effort, but that's just the beginning. The company that manufactures these microchips is planning to invent implants that can track a wearer's live vital signs and inform them when there's something wrong with their health. The company also hopes that people will soon consider storing their medical information on encrypted RFID chips, and the group is working on a way to make GPS-enabled chips available as an option for families to track relatives suffering from severe dementia or Alzheimer's. This all sounds fantastic, but that doesn't mean everybody welcomed the chip with open arms. a lot of people feel apprehensive about it. Some skeptics are sure that these chips will soon have GPS trackers in them. It's quite possible that it'll all start with big companies wanting to track their employees' locations. The fact that certain businesses want to provide the service for free is really what got people a little uneasy about this point. But it might not all be a conspiracy theory. I mean, do you think your boss would be interested to know how you spend your weekends, how long your break actually lasted, and whether you were really home during your sick leave? And finally, of course, there's always the classic Big Brother will use it to keep tabs on people thing. Naysayers are also against the idea of chipping because they say nobody can guarantee that the personal information contained in these chips will be secure. For example, criminals might steal private information in the chip. The chip's manufacturer assures their clients that everything is encrypted, but in theory, any data storage or device can be hacked. Others just feel uneasy about putting something inside their body, fearing it might be harmful for their health. There were concerns that a small metallic foreign body could trigger cancer, but the risks of cancer caused by RFID have since been found to be virtually non-existent for humans and negligible for animals. One 2016 study in the Department of Bioengineering at the University of Washington State even suggested that implanting active RFID chips within cancerous tumors could be an effective means of treatment. Now, that's an unexpected twist, don't you think? But still, a lot of people are not okay with the idea of getting checked. And their main proof point is that this new technology is the first step into turning us into cyborgs. Well, while some are scared of it, others dream about it. They're totally on board with transforming the human body by developing and making sophisticated technologies widely available to enhance people's physical, mental, and psychological capabilities. But this is really nothing new. Doctors started implanting electronic devices and machine-like metal into people a long time ago. I'm talking, of course, about things like pacemakers. The very first electrocardiac pacemaker implementation was performed in 1958 at the Karolinska Institute in Sweden by surgeon Rune Elmquist and Anke Senning. Man, the Swedes started this one too? Before that, pacemakers were about the size of a hockey puck and worked on two transistors located outside the body. As you can guess, patients who got them couldn't choose a very active lifestyle. Nowadays, pacemakers are not only becoming more and more sophisticated and reliable, they're also getting smaller and lighter. This means that people with heart disease can lead a more comfortable life and enjoy a lot of fun activities just like the rest of us. Another example of technology helping people live longer and more comfortably is bionic prosthetics. They're built to imitate the work of a lost organ, and they work through nerve impulses. Just several years ago, such devices could substitute only a leg or an arm, but now there are prosthetics for organs as complex as the ear and eye. So, what's your opinion about technology becoming a part of the human body? Let everybody know in the comments below. Don't forget to give this video a like, share it with your friends, and click subscribe to always stay on the bright side of life.